Burgess Battery Company was founded in Chicago, Illinois on March 2, 1917, a division of Northern Chemical Engineering Laboratories founded by Charles F. Burgess, a professor of electrical engineering at the University of Wisconsin. The company began in Madison, Wisconsin, and quickly expanded to three factories in the USA. By 1923, the company had opened a single Canadian factory in Niagara Falls. The Canadian Burgess Battery Factory was built in 1922 on Buttry Street. A heavy industry area supported by an extensive transportation network, including rail, water, and the nearby border crossing into Michigan. The area began drawing in large industry in the early 1900s due to its inexpensive hydroelectric power provided by the nearby Niagara River. The Burgess Battery Company was a major employer in the area, with multiple members of the same family working at the factory. Several former employees even mentioned the company in their obituaries. They manufactured dry cell batteries, which are zinc containers filled with active chemicals and a brass-capped carbon rod. The batteries were advertised as a convenient, economical, and safe source of electrical energy. Burgess batteries were used mainly for radios, but were also used in telephones, flashlights, and other technologies. Their main products were A, B, and C batteries, each with their own unique voltage capacity. Battery A was a standard 1-cell, 1.5-volt battery weighing 2 pounds. Battery B was 30 cells, 45 volts, and came in two size options, one weighing 9.5 pounds and the other at 14 pounds. Battery C was 3 cells, 1.5 volts, and came in two sizes, both weighing less than a pound. A 7.5 volt C battery was added to the lineup for special cases. After founder Charles Burgess died suddenly of a heart attack in 1945 without training a successor, the company began to struggle. The end of the Second World War led to many breakthroughs in the chemical makeup of a battery. The industry moved from dry cell to zinc carbon, and then later to alkaline batteries. The introduction of transistor technology in 1965 made dry cell batteries almost irrelevant. Burgess failed to adapt to the new market demands, waiting until patents had expired before pursuing them. And their attempts at the newer styles were low quality compared to their competition, Mallory brand, which is now known as Duracell. The company was shuffled through several owners between 1958 and 1974, before finally being acquired by Charles Pindyck Inc. The company that once boasted several thousand employees was whittled down to just over 100 by 1985. The Canadian factory was shut down in 1981, with the American portion of the business being shut down in 1989 and having its assets liquidated. The former Niagara Burgess Battery Factory was sold to Dorino Susan and became DLS Mechanical. They celebrated their 25th business anniversary at the factory in 2006. In 2008, the city hit the building with a prohibition of occupancy order, declaring the building a danger to workers. Another investigation in May of 2011 found multiple fire and safety code violations. Parts of the building were made off-limits while the company continued to work from the site. In 2014, the city fined Dorino Susan $100,000 after continued resistance and non-compliance regarding repairs on the building, a fraction of the fines on paper, which start at $20,000 per day that the order isn't complied with. This would have amounted to $19.5 million in fines. Susan claimed in court that he had spent $60,000 on repairs. The city disputed that the repairs did anything to secure the building. The judge appointed to the case even said he was shocked that the building hadn't exploded onto the street. A further two businesses are listed at the same address, Alder Equipment and Vector Tooling. The buildings were used mainly for storage before being abandoned entirely around 2017. The once prosperous industrial park that helped build Niagara's economy became full of vacant or abandoned factories and warehouses, juxtaposed with lived-in, small single-family homes that once housed factory workers. The area has been classified as generally unattractive to new business due to the age, condition, and quality of the properties. To try and spur new development, the city has taken it upon themselves to demolish the decaying structures. The former Burgess Battery Plant was demolished in the winter of 2020.